Our state park system is the envy of our nation. By area, Pennsylvania is the 33rd largest state in the country. But we have the third largest state park system in the United States. Nearly 1% of the land area of our state is part of our state park system. Our state park system is 123 years old. Today, we are considering a bill that could make permanent and irreversible changes to the magnificent park system that we enjoy, to the magnificent park system that we are elected to be stewards of. The budget bill we just voted a few minutes ago affects our state for 12 months. This bill before us today could affect our state park system for decades to come. Take a look at the bill in front of you. On page 3, line 22, this bill introduces it into our state parks the concept of hotels, amusement parks, water parks, outdoor sports facilities, and golf courses. On page 8, line 8, this bill empowers a private consultant to inventory our state parks and look for development opportunities. A private consultant. Our first state park was Valley Forge, which was purchased by Pennsylvania in 1893. It remained a state park for 83 years until Valley Forge was transferred to the national park system on the day of our nation's bicentennial in 1976. Thank goodness that our Pennsylvania state park system was an excellent steward over those years and that this historic site was preserved for future generations. And we should be thankful that our legislators of one century ago did not follow the same path that this bill asks us to follow today. What if those state officials had decided to take these acres and add a velodrome for bicyclists or a bicycle built for two, or maybe add a man-made lake for paddle boats or other recreational opportunities? What if they decided to add an amusement park, a merry-go-round, a roller coaster, or maybe some more roads for the motor cars, which were new in that time? There were lots of recreational opportunities available to the public a century ago, but thank goodness that our state leaders did not think it would be appropriate to remake our state park system with this kind of development. I've talked yesterday about how our state park system expanded during the tenure of Dr. Maurice Goddard, who served six governors as a cabinet secretary. The number of state parks was expanded by 45. In fact, the goal has been nearly reached to have a state park within 25 miles of everyone's home in Pennsylvania. And think about it. You do not need a water park in our state parks to appreciate our state's water resources. Just think of the limitless view of Lake Erie at Presque Isle State Park. Think of the sparkling waterfalls at Ricketts Glen. Remember and appreciate the recreational opportunities available at Nockamixon, or so many other state parks in Pennsylvania. You do not need an amusement park in your state parks to be amused by the wonders of nature here in Penn's Wood. Just think of the natural wonder of Archibald Pothole State Park. Just think of the magnificent treasure that we have. I have a list of all 123 state parks, from Hickory Run to Bald Eagle, to Beltsville, you name it. In every corner of this state, there's a magnificent state park to be appreciated by our generation and by future generations. Our state parks are spectacular. Our state parks are spectacular all on their own. Why are we talking about building amusement parks, golf courses, and water parks in the natural beauty that surrounds us in our state parks? How can we think that mankind can improve upon the handiwork of God? We are blessed in Pennsylvania with a wonderful legacy of preservation and conservation. Let us appreciate our state parks. Let us not turn our magnificent state park system into a series of public-private partnerships. Let's preserve our state parks for future generations. I urge a no vote on House Bill 2013.